Hi, Peter.
Hello.
How did you first get into animation?
I never expected to go into animation. I was an illustrator who did lots of work for magazines and books. But I did illustrate a children's book called Finn McCool, sort of a children's book, children's video, about an Irish giant. And someone at Disney, a producer there, saw the work and thought, why don't we ask him if he wants to work on The Hunchback of Notre Dame? And I said, sure. And ever since, I've been working on one film or another. I worked for, you know, Disney and DreamWorks and Pixar and everybody. But then I got involved with Blue Sky, who do the Ice Age movies, and they happily are also on my side of the world. They're on the East Coast.
Okay. In terms of your inspiration, have you based the new Ice Age characters on people you know or any famous faces?
Not specifically, although my wife would claim that they're all based on me. And there is, she could make a case for that. I mean, there are elements to some of the characters that, depending on my mood, I think you would recognize in the films. But there is a character in this film that is one of the only ones that I based directly on somebody I know. And that is my nephew, Wyler. He, when he was a little younger, he was kind of a like kid with hair in his eyes and, you know, a little bit of an attitude. And Sid, in this, meets his family again, and he has a younger brother whose name is, I can't remember his name, but he's in the film, and that sloth looks exactly like my nephew, Wyler.
Does he know he's the sloth?
Yes, he does. He's actually secretly proud of it, I think. I think he put it on his Facebook page.
So, going back to when you were at school, was art your favorite subject, or did you have a passion before drawing?
As I was growing up, looking back at it, I see a few passions that all sort of converged. I loved to draw. I always loved to draw. I always loved animals. And at some point, I was really into puppets, too. I was into figures. And that really translates into 3D characters. So I was always fascinated by characters. Even when whatever I was drawing, it was always, I would never bother drawing something if it didn't have some character interplay in there. So a few of my passions kind of converged, I'm very happy to say.
Okay. So what advice would you give to our readers that want a career in animation?
I would say to anybody interested in pursuing anything you love, whether it's animation or drawing or music or whatever, if you love it, you work at it. Even if people tell you you're the most talented one in the class, that's great, but that's not going to be enough. Even more important is your desire to do it and your willingness to work at it. But working at something like that is, it's the most important thing you can do in your life, to be able to, as I do, and I consider myself incredibly fortunate, to actually do work that is fun, that I can be proud of, and that keeps me interested and passionate. I think it should be everybody's goal. And I really, really encourage you to try to find out what it is that you love to do.
Okay. Thank you so much for your time. I really appreciate it.
Thank you
and
very much.
And best of luck with Ice Age 5.
Thank you. If there is one, nobody said so, but
there should be.
There probably will be.
Thank you.
Thank you.